Hey guys, this is Austin from Awick Auto, and today we're going to be showing you how to make a spray paint job look decent. So, as you can see, I already have a lot of my new body panels on, and all my Bondo on there, and most of the truck is taped off. I'm not going to tape all of it off because it'd just be a waste, and I'm just going to be careful with where I'm spraying. So, we've got it all stripped down to bare metal, and now we're going to block sand it with 220 grit to make sure we get all the little imperfections out, and then we'll carry on from there.
Learning on, keeping this turntable spinning, everything from Jones to Jennings, slowly planning my survival in a 3-foot stack of vinyl. Since you had to walk out of here, I've been having a record.
Alright, now that we have it all sanded down with the 220 grit, we're going to wipe down everything we just sanded and everything we're going to paint with a wax and grease remover. And that way it's going to get off all the dust and all the wax from us touching it. And afterwards, we want to make sure we're not touching this with our fingers, because we're just going to have to redo it. So, we're going to start.
I bet you thought before you left, I'd just sit in silence by myself. Turn this house into jail, dying slow and living hell, but love's got a funny way.
Alright, so we have everything wiped down with wax and grease remover. Everything looks pretty good, and I'm not going for any type of good quality on this vehicle. I'm just trying to improve the looks a little bit, so I'm not trying to do a perfect job by any means. So now we're going to put on some filler primer, and we're going to lay it on a little wet so we can sand it down, and we're going to get started. You want to feather your edges first. So you're going to outline the entire truck pretty much of where you're going to paint, and then work your way inward. You want to start from the edge and just work your way up pretty much. You're not going to be able to get a very wet coat using an aerosol can, so it's going to dry on you pretty fast. Nothing to worry about there. As long as you're overlapping your sprays, you're overlapping about half of your previous spray, you're going to be all right, and it's going to come out decent doing it this method. So. Now we're gonna get started.
Hey, you're keeping score, and you're leaving lit up my scoreboard. I usually make it through Saturday sober. All bets are off when I flip her over. One bourbon, I want scotch, one beer. I'm having a record year. Quarter notes and Hank's halftime. A pounding on this heart of mine. Song to song, I pass my time. These speakers on TV. Having a record year. You're leaving, left me going crazy. I'm counting on a needle to save me. I'll drop it in the groove, and we go round and round and down in a spiral. I guess I really ought to call and thank you. I rediscovered red-headed stranger. Got down with old James Brown.
Alright, now that we got our first coat of primer, I can see some spots where I should have put more glazing putty, or I should have touched up more. You can see some holes where the Bondo was. I'm not too worried about it, because like I said, I'm not going for a great finish. I just wanted the paint to be better, because all the clear coat was coming off and it's starting to look really bad. So, in reality, I should have went back and fixed some of it. And on the back side of the cab, you can see that I clearly didn't care too much about it, because there are quite a few spots. You can see some gaps in the Bondo, and there's a small hole there. But I'm really not too worried about it, because, like I said, it's going to look 10 times better than it used to. So, our first coat of primer on. It's a good time to stay hydrated and shotgun a beer. So our first coat of primer had about 10 minutes to dry after our little hydration break. So I got this can all shaken up, and we're ready to start our second coat. We want to do one more light coat. So the first coat we want to do light, second coat a light, and then we can make it a little bit heavier. That way it can build up. So we're going to do one more light coat, overlapping sprays this time as well.
Mm-hmm. was the summer before the real world started, and the deal was we would get to go if we cleaned it up and got it running. That is old Winnebago, winging a prayer down a 65, five best friends on four ball ties.
Alright, I'm going to give you some quick tips on how to spray with an aerosol can. First off, you want to make sure your can is always shaking. I know I spend a little too long spraying before I shake, but if it's still spraying alright, I don't really bother. You should shake every 30 seconds so you make sure the can is well mixed. And another good tip, you don't want to wave your hand back and forth like that. You want to keep your hand straight and keep about 8 to 10 inches away and move your whole body with the spray. You don't want to be fanning your paint around. So make sure you're about 8 to 10 inches away and you move your whole body from side to side. That way you're getting even coverage the entire time you're spraying and you're getting everything covered. Alright, so we gave our second coat about 10 minutes to dry, so we're ready for our third. The third one we're going to move a little bit slower, so we put a little more primer on so we can black sand it afterwards. And so now we're going to go ahead and get started.
Still see Billy smiling when we finally made it to Talladega. Boys raise the whiskey in gold glass. Now here's to turning up or slowing down in cars that go real fast. We were laughing and living, drinking and wishing and thinking as that checkered flag was waving.
Alright, so we have our third coat of primer applied now, and usually you could sand it with a 600 grit if you wanted to get really picky about it, but we're doing this back to back and not a lot of dust is going to get on it, so I'm not too worried. Worst case scenario, we can sand it, wet sand it after paint and clear and worry about it then, but it looks pretty good right now. And like I said, not going for super great quality, so I'm not going to waste time sanding it. So we're going to give it 30 minutes to dry, maybe a little less depending on the weather, and then we'll go ahead and start painting. Alright, so we gave our last coat of primer about 30 minutes to dry, so now it's ready to paint. I'm just using Duplicolor Perfect Match. It's available at pretty much every auto parts store. It's a little pricey, but we just want to test it out and see how well of a paint job we can actually do with a rattle can. So we're essentially going to do the exact same thing with the paint as we did with the primer. We're going to feather our edges by going around where we want to paint and then work our way in. That's about it. A lot of times when you're painting, you want to have a wet coat with your paint. With the aerosol cans, it dries so fast and the paint coming out of there is so thin that you can't really get a wet coat, so we're not going to worry about that too much. The clear is really going to make this paint shine, so it's going to look kind of crappy at first when we lay it on there, but we're not going to worry about that, and we're just going to keep on laying it down. So here we go.
Sure would like to stay in Talladega. Like a stone, time rolls on. It pauses, that's just a deal. Most days in life don't stand out, but life's about those days that we all like. Rockin' Randall, getting rowdy, shooting Roman candles at the man in the moon till the Alabama sun was breaking. Over Talladega, boys raised the whiskey in your glass. Here's to turn it up, slowing down, in cars that go real fast. We were laughing and living, drinking and wishing, and thinking as that checkered flag was waving. Sure life to stay.
Alright, so the secret to our rattle can paint job is this clear right here. I get it at Painter Supply. And this is really what's going to make our paint job come out looking really nice. This stuff has a little button on the bottom. You're gonna press that button in once you get it, and then that's gonna activate the two-part clear, and you're gonna shake it really well, and then same exact thing we've been doing. You're gonna apply it to the paint job, and the stuff goes on really nice and really makes the paint job, really brings it to light. I already put one coat of this clear on, and there's a little bit of orange peel to it, but I'm not too worried about it. Hopefully some of it will come out when I wet sand it and polish it. So we're gonna go ahead and put the clear coat on just like we did the paint and the primer. So we put our third coat of clear and we're pretty much done now. I'm gonna give it about a week to dry out and then I'll probably wet sand and polish it. So this is how it's gonna look for now, but it comes out pretty darn good, I think, for doing a rail can. A lot of times you see rail can jobs and they look like complete crap because no one really tries too hard. And I think this is a pretty simple way and it looks 100 times better. That was just a quick rundown on how to make a rail can paint job look decent.